Hi, friends, and welcome to Game Day Eve here on GoJacks.com, as tomorrow the Jackrabbit football team will venture out to Bozeman, Montana, where a sellout crowd of over 17,000 awaits as SDSU will take on Montana State. Alongside Mike Struck, I'm Tyler Merriam. Jackrabbits, an impressive way to start the season, 51-13 over Duquesne a little more than a week ago.
Yeah, the Jacks certainly got off to a good start. Offense got rolling early, put some points on the board, and really set that defense up to play with the lead and allow them to be very aggressive through the course of the game, and got a lot of young guys some playing action and get them some experience and get their feet wet.
Eight true freshmen had their red shirts pulled on Thursday night.
That's unbelievable. I just don't recall in all of my years of following Jackrabbit football, and especially under Coach Stig, that he's really pulled that many red shirts and brought that many young guys into the program this early.
How about the Wizard, Jake Winicky? He had almost every SDSU receiving record known to man. He added to it. He's the career receptions record holder now, on top of receiving yards, on top of receiving touchdowns. And oh, by the way, he tied a Missouri Valley and school record with four touchdown catches against Duquesne.
Well, that guy's just a playmaker, and you know, we were joking about it on the radio last week that all he does is catch touchdowns. And boy, just the plays that he makes and the confidence that that offense has in him, and Taryn Christian just throwing the ball up there and really letting Jake go make a play, and the results speak for themselves.
We talked a lot about the young front seven. We mentioned some of those true freshmen that got to play. They played very well. The entire front seven did in the opener.
Well, that's what I was probably most optimistic about coming out of the game, is all of those young guys. And granted, it maybe wasn't quite the caliber of play that you're going to see in the Missouri Valley Football Conference, but those guys did a very good job of really holding their own at the line of scrimmage and allowing those linebackers to move and work in space, and pleasantly surprised with the results that came last Thursday night.
All right, let's talk about tomorrow and Montana State. We begin with the fact this is a program coming off an FBS game at Washington State, much different opener than the Jacks had, a nationally ranked foe. They were very competitive in that game, only down 14-0 at half.
Well, yeah, and I taped it so I could watch it a little bit later, and I went back and was watching that game, and when I got to the fourth quarter, and it's 21-0, and I was just kind of shocked, because knowing that Washington State with Mike Leach, how he likes to throw the ball around and explosive offense, and I got to watch, and I thought that Montana State's defense did what they needed to do to keep them in the game. I would expect that we're going to see a little bit different defense out of them this week when they face the Jackrabbits, but they played a lot of soft coverage, tried to keep the receivers underneath them and force them to drive the field on them, and that Montana State defense did a really nice job of rallying to the football, and not a lot of yards after catch. They're a very athletic defense, and they can run sideline to sideline.
And they were very conservative in their approach against Washington State, but like you said, so athletic. Let's talk offensively a little bit. The name that jumps out is Chris Murray, the Big Sky Freshman of the Year, became the starter second half of the season for Montana State, and he truly is a run-pass dual-threat quarterback.
He is a dual-threat quarterback, and it's one of those quarterbacks that the Jacks have had problems with in the past. Very good at running the option, and what they do with their offense really makes you defend the whole field. One of the knocks on him has been maybe his passing ability, but he's certainly worked on that in the offseason. But he's a guy that, they like the ball in his hands because he's able to make things happen when he has the football.
And again, this part of that Missouri Valley Big Sky Challenge, this a tough road game for the Jacks and a sellout crowd of over 17,000. First time on the road, a new experience for a lot of these young guys, and it'll be a very loud environment for Taryn Christian in that offense.
It is an environment that, it's going to be new for some of these guys, but if you want to be a top team in the FCS, you've got to get used to playing in front of hostile fans, and it'll be a good test for them to enter the conference season. So, certainly looking for the Jacks at least to rely on those veterans to maintain their composure and get the team ready to go.
What are you most excited about for this trip to Bozeman personally?
Biscuits and gravy, baby.
Western Cafe, we're coming for you on Saturday morning. Saturday night, 7 o'clock Central Time, the kick between South Dakota State and Montana State. Join us and Scotty Quaz beginning at 6 o'clock on the Jackrabbit Sports Network.